You're watching IEMG.
You're watching IEMG, and the next time that you go online, you get on YouTube, search Inland Empire Media Group, and when you find it, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. We'll let you know the next time we go live with a game broadcast or upload the latest segment of your favorite show right here on IEMG. And welcome to IEMG Sports Weekly Fall League Champions Edition. I'm Pep Fernandez, and it was another great year for the city of San Bernardino this fall, including on the cross-country trails. We got the, how does this sound, Mountain Valley League champion boys cross-country team from Indian Springs High School. Congratulations, Coyotes. Coach Sun in the house. And Coach, this is the first league title in boys cross-country, right, for the school?
Yes, that's correct. This is the first league title for both boys and girls for cross-country. And this is the first time the school basically has ever made it to CIF finals as well. So, you know, both of them are historic firsts. I'm excited. You know, we got a, even though we have a lot of seniors on varsity, we got a pretty young team coming up. So I'm excited about the future as well.
Did you see kind of the writing on the wall for this team, knowing that you had such a strong senior class? Like, hey, you know what? We might have a pretty decent year.
Not necessarily. I'm usually confident with, in terms of our training, in terms of the assistant coaches and stuff we have on staff. But just because this is my second year, basically, as the head coach and at the helm, they exceeded all expectation. I didn't think this was going to be possible until the third year where we make it to CIF finals, because Rubidoux was tough.
Yeah.
You know, Rubidoux had Kevin Ramos, and of course,
last couple of years,
the last few years, which is a blessing in disguise for us, because these guys, what they did was they watch how a champion prepare, they watch how a champion practice and such, and you know, they were a great beacon and such for our team basically to follow. And I think, you know, we're just blessed to have all those teams in the league, as well as being introduced to you know, your Royal Valleys of the world, Sanjee, all of the teams that were successful, you know, San Bernardino High School,
their girls.
Yes, and they saw how to prepare. And that's what, you know, these guys latched on, how they built basically themselves.
Got your assistant coach too over here. You mentioned assistant coaches.
Yes.
And they're so important to a program.
They are.
And Kanani Soul over here.
Yes, sir.
And Kanani, let me ask you real quick. Strengthen the pack, right? I mean, like, you don't have to have just one dominant runner. I mean, you've got a bunch of great runners, and I'd have to go back and look at the league finals and where they place, but, you know, a bunch of sixth or seventh or eighth or ninth places will add up pretty quickly, and that's how you guys won league, wasn't it?
Oh, absolutely, and I think it even goes to speak towards our team culture of kind of like being a family. And I think how they run is, you know, they run for each other, and so I think that's also how they compete, which is a beautiful, beautiful message, really.
Eric Ramos,
yes,
talk about this year. Talk about the strength in the pack that you guys, did you kind of push each other, whether it was in practice or an actual race?
So for us this year, we really ingrained it to our, like, just the whole team. It wasn't just varsity, to where even the last guy, whoever it may be, they may not be the fastest, they might not be necessarily on the best level, but they're going to perform to a point where we're all happy with it. And, you know, it, like, really translated to races. You know, you had guys, like, you know, whenever one of us wouldn't perform, you had the rest of us performing and picking up that one guy. And you know what? It helps to not dwell on it, you know, and it really just created a really nice culture for us to where we could all depend on each other.
Let's go to the sophomore over here, Josue Ramirez, and really had a breakout sophomore season here for the Coyotes. Josue, what do you remember about this season, and what's kind of your own expectations for next year?
He had a breakthrough season. We told him last year he's going to be one of the best, basically, to ever come out of the school. And, you know, last year as a freshman, he didn't get it figured out till the end of the season. But this year he took ownership of it, and from the get-go, you know, he was on it. And then that's also due to the seniors and stuff we have on staff. You know, for the most part, it was a great leadership, you know, a great core of guys that just held each other accountable.
Josue, what clicked this year for you? Was there something that you did differently? Was training a little bit different? Did you take it more serious? What kind of was different this year?
I took it a little bit more serious. And then I just trust in my training, like Coach says, like, just trust in your training. And I did. Because, like, last year, like, I didn't really trust it, but, like, he said to trust in my training, and I did. And then thanks to all the boys too.
And it showed in the results, right? I mean, yeah. The proof was in the pudding, right?
Yes,
when
sir.
You guys were doing well. Let's go to the back row, to the G-Man. I have all these guys write their names down. I'm like looking down. I'm like, oh, G-Man, Gennaro Serrato in the back. What do you remember about the season? By the way, nice league champion shirts. You guys already got them. Yeah. Didn't waste any time to get those league champion shirts. But G-Man, what do you remember from about this season? And maybe pushing these younger guys, the couple sophomores who really burst onto the scene, kind of helping them along the way, I guess.
What I remember the most about this season is actually, I guess, the behind the scenes kind of. It's not really the races or all the medals, all the flashy pictures. It's really just the training that we did. We've been going since summer all the way through the entire season. In between every races, we put in work. Every morning, too, we would try and get together and run some extra miles in just to put that work in. And it paid off in the end.
Let's go to Eduardo Lara, who's a sophomore. You've got to love the work, right? I mean, you gotta be able to want to get up early and put in those extra miles and whatnot. Because if you don't love it, it's gonna feel like work, right? Did you enjoy the training sessions with these guys?
Yeah, I enjoyed it. They're like my family, so.
But you got to enjoy it, right?
Yeah, I enjoyed it, yeah.
I mean, some people would be like, cross country, that's crazy. You guys run for fun, right? But you got to love it. Let's go to Jesus Fuentes over here in the middle. And again, one of the seniors here. Jesus, when you looked at this team, you knew that there was a lot of talent across the board. Did you know, like, if you guys could all place well enough that you would have a chance to win league?
Yes, I actually thought that we could win league because, like, we all worked hard that the whole summer. And then coming into season, we all still worked hard and then practiced hard. And then when races came, we all just did well. We had to do.
So now let's go to Juan Sanchez because, I mean, Coach mentioned it. In the Mountain Valley League, I mean, Rubido's had a fantastic run. They had Kevin Ramos and San Bernardino's had some strong teams. MVL's good for cross country. Mm-hmm. What did you guys think about going into that league finals? Like, okay, this is the game plan. This is what we have to do to get that league championship. What was that game plan for you guys?
Well, our course was hilly, so we went before, I think a couple of days before, and we're just mapping out. We're saying, oh, we got to go fast, we got to pick up our legs. So we were just preparing mentally, too. We were telling each other, like, oh, we got this, we could do this, and we'll push ourselves. And then when we see someone, like, oh, like, they're down, we just tell them, like, oh, we got this, we've been training hard, we've been doing all this work, and then just got it.
All right, let's go to Pedro Farrell over here on the end. Pedro, as guys are coming across the finish line, are you trying to do math in your head like, oh man, we need this guy to come in this place? Or, I mean, how quickly did you know you guys won the league title as a team?
Well, first off, it would always be me being the seventh runner. I would always have to look around where my closest guy is. If I'm looking for Jesus, I always got to try to stick up to him. If I can't be near him, I always have to pick it up, always remember what Coach Sun always reminded me. Just to don't stop, always keep picking it up. And it was always the drive, the ambition of everything just to win was what always drove me to get through that finish line.
And Coach, we will round it out with this. I mean, when you put in so much training, so much hard work, how good does it feel to kind of see it pay off and win that league title?
It feels good because it's a reflection off of all of their hard work as well as the assistant coaches, the administration. Everybody backed us throughout the entire year. So, you know, I could honestly say we're blessed basically from the top to the bottom with having great athletes as well as the support and stuff within the community.
Well, it all came together. Great coach, yes, great assistant coach, great senior class, some young runners on the rise, right? I mean, so
yes, sir.
Looks like the program's in pretty good hands.
Yes, sir.
Tell John Chamberlain to, you know, keep those cool warm-ups coming or wherever those came from, right?
Definitely, I will. Thank you.
Congratulations, guys.
Thank you, Pat. Thank you.
Awesome. First league title for boys or girls, right, for
yes,
cross-country
sir.
At Indian Springs High School. So your Mountain Valley League champions. Congrats, and hopefully we'll see you again on the couch next season.
Definitely.
All right. That's Indian Springs Boys Cross Country, your Mountain Valley League champions. We'll be back with more here on IEMG Sports Weekly Fall League Champions Edition.
You're watching IEMG, and the next time that you go online, you get on YouTube, search Inland Empire Media Group, and when you find it, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. We'll let you know the next time we go live with a game broadcast or upload the latest segment of your favorite show right here on IEMG.
You're watching IEMG.